Hey, what's going on, guys? It's Mike for Sim Racing 604, and today I am going to be talking about single player racing. If you've been following the channel for some time, you guys know I like the single player racing. It just fits more with my schedule, and I really, really enjoy it. And a lot of people ask me, well, how can you enjoy it? There's so many flaws in the AI and modern sims and things like that. And that is actually true, but there are some things I do to help increase my enjoyment, and I'm going to pass those along to you because I think single player racing is not something you should have to do without. I really enjoy it, and I think you should too. And I guess to preface this, the first thing we should understand is that AI will never be perfect. I think we have some vision in our mind of AI in sim racing, least of all, being at some ex machina level. But let's face it, it's not going to be there anytime soon. So we sort of have to bend to AI instead of AI bending around our habits. So with that in mind, let's jump into it. So the first tip I would have is for you to start on a lower difficulty. So it seems like a sort of bragging right to be able to put your sim at level 100 or even above 100 to do some single player racing, and if your difficulty is that high, somehow that makes you cooler. I don't know about that. For me personally, I will start it lower and kind of work my way up, especially if I'm learning with a new car or track. And I promise you, since it's single player, your friends will never know. Starting it too high, you're going to be pushing yourself, and you're not going to be able to sort of adapt and learn anything about the AI. So my advice to you is to start a bit lower. If you normally run 100, try 80, then bump it up to 85 after a few laps, then to 90 after a few laps, and so on and so on. Taking it a bit slower will help you learn sort of the patterns of the AI and will get you to a happy place much faster, I promise you. Second tip, a little bit of extra braking goes a long way. So what I typically do when I'm racing, not qualifying, but racing, is I tap the brakes quite a bit before corner entry. You guys have probably noticed that in recent videos. It's only a recent discovery for me, but it's increased my pleasure massively because what I find is that the AI will respect your braking, but you might have a tough time adapting to their braking. They might brake at funny points. They might brake really, really early or something like that, and you end up crashing into the back of them and you say, well, why the heck did they brake there? They didn't need to, or something like that. But if you tap your brakes lightly, nice and early, typically the AI in most sims will respect that and give you the space you need to execute your turn in. So a little bit of early braking goes a long way. And third tip, if you have a need for single player racing in your life and you're stuck and you're hating life, give automobilista or rFactor 2 a try if you're on PC, obviously. And those are kind of lesser known sims still to this day. You guys have seen the channel recently. I've been driving a lot of automobilista, also known as AMS, and that and rFactor 2 are both phenomenal sims for the PC, but unfortunately lesser known. But the AI in both those games is really, really outstanding. I find that automobilista is probably my personal favorite, although I don't have a strict scale to judge it by. I just really enjoy how the AI behaves. There's been times where I've been in races and been side by side with somebody for about 30 seconds, each respecting each other's space, holding to lines, and it's just been really, really great. So that might be your best option if you are looking to do some single player racing. And the fourth and final tip is something I try and add to any of these lists is have fun. I see so many people freaking out and saying their race got ruined by stupid AI and blah, 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 taking it to Reddit, taking it to YouTube, taking it to Twitter. I get it. I get the frustration. Trust me, at times I get angry, but don't take it too seriously. Remember, above all else, it is a video game. As much as you want to call it a sim or anything else, and that's fine, it is still, at the end of the day, a video game, not something worth pulling your hair out over. And the more fun you have, the more sort of open-minded you are going into a single-player race and realizing that, again, it's just a game, the better your experience is going to be. And sort of akin to that, item 4.5, I guess you could call it, is that remember, AI is generally getting better over time. Sure, there's some modern sims that aren't as good as older sims you could name. That is very much true. But overall, in sim racing and racing games, the AI is improving, so this will get better. So, yeah, look forward to that. Again, hoping it gets to that Ex Machina level. Maybe. Someday in the very, very distant future. All right, guys, that is going to do it. I hope you've got something from this. Again, single player racing is something I do quite a lot of, and I really, really enjoy it. But I've just kind of had to adjust myself to the AI, knowing that the AI at this stage cannot necessarily adjust to me. Good luck. Have fun. Let me know which sims you enjoy single player racing in, or if you've just given up on it entirely. Thanks, guys, for watching, and we will see you next time.